Hi, thanks for tuning in. We're broadcasting today from the U.S. Department of Labor's Employment and Training Administration. I'm Robin Fernkus. I'm the director of our Division of Strategic Investments, and we're the fortunate group that gets to administer the Trade Adjustment Assistance Community College and Career Training Program, which we fondly call TACT.
And I'm Cheryl Martin. I'm the program manager for the TACT grant program, and we're going to talk a little bit about where TACT started and what it has achieved. So, Robin.
Looking back, it was a $1.9 billion investment that Congress gave us that was really unique in that it was designated for the funding of community college capacity building rather than focused on training, which is what our usual programs do. Congress passed the funding for the grants in 2010, and the Department of Labor awarded the first grants back in 2011. As we awarded those grants, and even today, we had very lofty goals and aspirations for this program. As many of you know, at that time, the economy was still a major challenge. We were in the midst of our recession. The unemployment rate was very high, with a number of seasoned workers losing their jobs for the very first time in their careers. Consequently, the administration focused these grants on helping community colleges build the capacity to help unemployed adults get retrained with relevant credentials and back to work while still completing their programs of study. So getting them to become lifelong learners was also a secondary goal, as occupations and industries are changing so rapidly. So we started out focusing on redesigning the programs of study, and over time we really evolved into thinking more broadly about how to change systems, particularly in thinking through accelerated learning strategies for adults. So many of the grantees you hear from or you've heard from in this field guide took on these challenges and really surpassed what we had envisioned. So we're really excited with what they've done. The grantees featured in this field guide have innovated in establishing sector strategies, building career pathways, engaging employers, and deploying navigators and other forms of student supports. They've developed competency frameworks, competency-based curriculum, and credit for prior learning, which was really key in helping these adult workers access their training and complete it faster than they would have in traditional curriculum. So work-based learning models such as apprenticeships, internships, and more are really helping these participants move into employment more efficiently or effectively. So many of the grantees really took advantage of these funds to make systemic or statewide changes to the way they do business. And that was really whether they made a particular curriculum for a particular occupation like welding consistent across the state, or they built statewide career pathway systems supported by their student navigators, or they integrated their data collection across independently run community colleges and then took the next step by integrating that data with the workforce system. So given all that the TAC grantees have done, it's really critical to be able to share the success of these college level and systemic innovations with a broader audience. So we're so pleased that you're tuning in, because we really would like for you to leverage the work that they've done. Sharing these innovations was our goal when we required our grantees to openly license this curriculum. And Skills Commons was really just a theoretical concept until we teamed up with Cal State University to develop a repository for the curriculum and many of the other materials that the grantees developed so that these resources can be shared with anyone else who can use them. So we're really delighted to see this field guide for the workforce innovation unfolding, and as one part of the repository to highlight just a few of the resources that are available on Skills Commons and to help many people, or as many people as possible, get a closer look at the innovations that the TAC grantees have put into practice to benefit their adult learners, as the not only as the colleges did during the grant period, but into the future.
I'm Cheryl Martin. I'm the program manager for the TACT program and work closely with Robin on this. I've been privileged to observe, along with Robin, the work of the TAC grantees over the past few years. And I have to say, it's been really exciting to see the video interviews in this field guide and to see a really, you know, small sampling of some of the many amazing stories that TAC grantees have to tell. When I think about TACT, many words come to mind, but two of them are huge and complex. So when you're trying to summarize what the what has happened as a result of TAC and what these grantees have done in such a short time, it's really hard. But there are at least seven things that are in my elevator speech about what TAC has accomplished. And, you know, we'll try to keep it a short elevator ride. But it might have to be a very tall building if you were really talking all about TAC. So here we go. First, the 700 colleges funded through TACT have built thousands of new employer relationships, and you hear about some of those in the stories that you're hearing in the field guide. Second, TACT grantees have defined hundreds of career pathways aligned with industry-recognized credentials, and participants have earned more than 320,000 credentials to date. We're still waiting for another round of reporting as we speak here. Third, at the core of TACT, grantees developed or enhanced nearly 2,700 programs of study. So that might actually sound like kind of a small number, 2,700, you know, but when you think about that in the context of what it takes to develop one program of study and get it across the finish line, get it approved and all of that, that's a monumental task. So that was done 2,700 times so far. And on this floor of our elevator ride, I'll pause to say that those programs of study have been used to create the world's largest open educational resources project featuring job-driven workforce development materials. And of course, that's Skills Commons. Further, related to those 2,700 newly minted programs of study, the colleges have trained more than 475,000 adult workers. So now I'm imagining seeing, like, from the top of the Washington Monument or something, you know, on the mall here in D.C., those 475,000 workers spread out across the mall, and that is quite a crowd. I wonder if we can get them to organize themselves to spell out TACT. Maybe that's the only time it's useful to have such a long acronym, because we have a lot of people to fit into that. But anyway, it's an awesome view when you think about those 475,000 folks. But that's not all. Going up. So fourth, the 700 TACT-funded colleges significantly enhanced their infrastructure through updated equipment and facilities. So they not only developed those programs of study, but they made them much better and for the learners because they had better equipment to use. Fifth, many colleges worked to boost college completion through developmental ed reform or student navigators or credit for prior learning, or the kinds of system-wide changes that you're seeing in the field guide here. And sixth, we can't neglect to mention how much these colleges strengthened workforce partnerships. These and employer partnerships are the keys to success in workforce development efforts. And many grantees told us that that was a really big part of what happened through TACT, and that they, you know, as hard as that was, they really benefited from that. And finally, TACT colleges are helping to build the evidence base for what works in skills training for adults. Besides systemic changes, besides sustaining programs of study and all these other things that people have been doing, besides sharing TACT-funded resources with anyone who wants them on Skills Commons, the evaluation materials that have already come out and will come out about TACT is another really big part of the TACT legacy. grantees themselves produce more than 200 individual third-party evaluations, which are available on Skills Commons, as well as participating in several national evaluations that are just beginning to tell the story from an evidence point of view. So, wow, the view from up here is amazing.
Yes.
Given all of that, it's so important to measure the success of the innovations through efforts like this field guide so others can leverage the amazing work that grantees did. So we're very excited about the field guide and its role in sharing the story of TACT success and TACT innovation, and therefore in helping others scale and sustain what has been accomplished through TACT. We appreciate the grantees who went the second mile to help tell the stories you're finding here in the field guide. And we definitely appreciate all the efforts put into building Skills Commons, this robust online repository which spreads the benefit of TACT to an even wider audience. I'll end by saying that grantees often thank us for bringing TACT to them, but really the thanks belong to the grantees who worked so hard to make their proposals into realities that often went beyond what they had originally envisioned. We hope that you will take full advantage of the exciting stories shared by TACT grantees in the Skills Commons Field Guide for Workforce Innovation.